Good morning everyone. I would like to explain power system operation and control with and will. Which means what I am teaching in the teacher's perspective. Will means what I am learning in the student's perspective. This power system operation and control comprising of 5 units. Among them, first 2 units are related to optimal operation of fuel-fired stations or thermal power stations. In the second unit, hydrothermal coordination for the optimal operation of hydropower stations as well as thermal power stations. So, I would like to focus on this optimal operation and what are the contents to be taught or to be explained for the student in detail, and in the student's perspective what students should understand and grasp from this subject in order to implement his knowledge or her knowledge in the practical field. Very first one, in the power system operation and control, the entire power system of the Indian electrical power system can be divided into 5 major grids. So very first one, northern grid. Second one is red color, eastern grid. Third one is blue color, western grid, and fourth one is green one, southern grid. The last one, violet color, northeast grid. All these 5 grids are operating, each of the grid is operating at constant frequency. Suppose the entire grid is operating, suppose 49 hertz. So the frequency of the whole grid is 49. It may not be same in the other grid. In one of the grids, the frequency may be 49.5 hertz. Therefore, all the grids are said to be control areas. We'll discuss the control area in detail in subsequent chapters. In the meantime, let me explain what is control area. Control area is nothing but the entire area which is comprising of generators, transmission lines, and loads connected together to operate them, all of them, at a constant or a particular frequency within the acceptable limits. The frequency of the operation may be 50 Hz plus or minus 2.5 Hz. In recent years, the frequency of operation is strictly limited to very low value. Variation is very low value, less than 1 Hz. Anyhow, that acceptable limit should be maintained. Therefore, within the control area, the frequency of operation is at the same value. It need not to be same in other areas. If you maintain the frequency of entire India at a same frequency, then it is combined as a single grid. 5 grids can be combined as single grid. Now the aim of the government is to combine the entire India as a single grid. In future, we will get that. A single grid concept. Where the frequency of entire India is same. In the meantime, let us discuss about different control areas. All these control areas are connected together with the tie lines, AC tie lines or HVDC links, so that the power can be exchanged between the control areas. Any two or more than two control areas can be exchanged as per terms and conditions as well as availability of the power in other areas. That has to be maintained. That is the operation of the power system. Our aim is not only to operate the power system securely, but also we have to operate the power system optimally. What is meant by optimum? Optimally means the cost of the energy must be very low value and required efforts are least. Then it is said to be optimal operation. So the cost of the electrical energy must be very low. That means you need to operate the generator in such a way that you will get the least cost, least operating cost for all the generating plants and load centers. Therefore, we can divide the power plants into two categories: fuel-fired stations, in which thermal power stations, gas power stations, nuclear power stations, all are fuel-fired stations in which energy is converted into steam. That steam is used to drive the rotor of the turbine, which is coupled to generator. Generator will generate the electrical energy. This is the process. In fuel-fired stations, the major part of the fuel-fired stations is nothing but which is obtained from the coal. Therefore, thermal power stations most important for us. In optimal operation, we will deal with thermal power stations or fuel-fired stations in the first unit. In the so therefore 40%, this is the generation of India from different type of power plants, in which thermal power stations contributes around 40% generation is from the thermal power stations or from the coal. So therefore, in the first unit we will discuss about thermal power plants. So entire each area, that means each zone, is comprising of so many generating plants, load center connected together with the transmission network. So therefore, transmission network will comprising of line losses, both active and reactive power losses. So therefore, optimal operation is comprising of without transmission line losses and with transmission line losses. We will get the operating condition for optimal operation without line losses and with line losses. And we will also solve some kind of problems, numerical problems, in that first unit. So that is the importance of operation of thermal power plants. Therefore, why I am teaching optimal operation of thermal power plants? The consumer should pay very low amount of electrical energy, low amount towards the electrical energy. So therefore it must be cheap, which is nothing but optimal operation. And hence, in order to supply the customer with the least cost, we need to study the optimal operation of thermal power stations. And hence, I need to teach optimal operation of thermal power plants. And why students should learn this? So, student has to learn in order to function the generating plants. So, in which student will may get the job as an electrical engineer. The aim of that electrical engineer is to supply the power with the least cost and reliability and quality. And hence, so student has to understand the optimal operation of thermal power plants. So coming to the major portion of generation is hydropower station. Around 16% is hydropower stations. Other non-conventional energy sources are 27%. So therefore we need to focus. The second thing is the operation of thermal and hydro power plants, the coordination for the least cost operation or optimal operation. It is also known as economic operation of hydrothermal power stations, including transmission line losses and without transmission line losses. So therefore, in the second unit, we will understand the coordination of thermal and hydro power plants. So thermal and hydro are fuel-fired stations and hydro power stations. All these, most of the plants, all these are fuel-fired stations. Hydro power station, which is operating with water, kinetic energy and potential energy of the water is used to rotate the turbine, and hence it doesn't involve any operating cost, although it may involve equivalent cost for the functioning of hydropower station. So anyhow, we will deal with it in the second unit. So therefore, in order to coordinate the hydropower station with the thermal power station, we need to study the hydrothermal coordination. And hence, I need to teach that coordination and optimal operation of hydrothermal power stations. This is one, this is two. Both should be coordinated. And hence, we need to study the coordination of hydrothermal power stations for the optimal operation. Therefore, student must focus on the coordination of hydrothermal plants. So this is thermal power plant, which includes the cooling towers and chimney. This is the power plant in which horizontal turbine is used. That means cylindrical type synchronous generator is used to generate the power, which is horizontally mounted turbine. So and hence coal handling plant, and then after that we'll have boiler in which steam is generated. That steam is admitted to the turbine through the valves, and the steam can be controlled with the valve mechanism, which will control the speed of the rotor of the turbine The turbine is coupled to the generator, horizontally mounted at very high speed, 3000 RPM or 3600 RPM. As per the frequency of operation. So therefore, that the rotor is rotated with the help of steam admitted through the valve mechanism, through the governor control, and then so that steam is used to rotate the rotor, which will control the output of the generator, electrical power output of the generator. So therefore, steam admission and output power of the generator are directly correlated. The thermal power plant, the efficiency of the thermal power plant is very low, around less than 30%, and hence there is a direct relationship between fuel input and the generated output. So therefore, both are related. Fuel input F and power generation PG, both are related with the approximate equations. So the fuel input comprising of burning of the coal, and hence burning of the coal will generate certain amount of steam. Therefore, fuel input is comprising of cost, the operating cost. If you want to burn certain amount of coal to get some amount of steam energy, we need to spend some amount. So that is the operating cost of the power plant. So the relation between operating cost and power generation can be explained in cost and incremental cost curves. So the cost curves are very important in thermal power plant, which is related to your optimal operation as well as cost of the generation. So and hence, in thermal power plants, the fuel input plays a vital role in deciding the pricing of electrical energy. Alright, so this is the thermal power plant and flow diagram. So this is the cooling tower, this is the chimney, here it is the transformer is there, this is the transmission line, and here it is the horizontally mounted generator. So this boiler will get the steam and then admit it to the turbine. The turbine is coupled to the generator. The generator will give the electrical power output. So this is the working of thermal power plant. Already you have understood in Power Systems 1 course. So each of the component will have its advantages as well as significance in the thermal power plant. Overall, the efficiency is very low because of the combustion of the coal. So when the high grade coal is employed, then the efficiency may improve. To improve the efficiency, some of the devices are employed: superheater, cooling tower, etc. Anyhow, in overall, it comprising of so many components with low efficiency. Of course, we have to depend on thermal power stations. Already you have seen that percentage is more than 40%, and hence we cannot divide the thermal power plant as per today's scenario, and hence we need to understand thermal power plant very clearly. So this is the core structure of unit 1 and 2, the economic operation of power systems, which we will deal with the incremental cost and cost curves, heat rate curves. That means cost curves, or different curves of the operation of thermal power plant, and the necessary condition for optimal operation of thermal power plant when losses are neglected, and then when losses are considered, what is the operation will understand, and then unit commitment in a particular power plant. So each generating station will have number of units. So how to operate the units in order to gain highest efficiency is a challenge. Anyhow, in the second unit, hydrothermal scheduling, in which thermal power plant and hydropower plant both are operated in coordination to reduce the cost of operation. Anyhow, in modeling of turbine, we'll see in unit 3. So this is unit 1, this is unit 2, and this is, we'll deal with the modeling of turbine in the third unit. That is the relevant part. So now, working of hydroelectric power plant, let us understand briefly. This is the vertically mounted generator. So this is the reservoir, dam is there. This reservoir will have some head, it will maintain some head. So through this head, the potential energy is stored in the water, and this is flowed through the penstock, and this potential energy is converted into kinetic energy and rotates the turbine rotor. This is the vertically mounted turbine coupled to the generator. So this rotation, this mechanical input, is converted into electrical power output. This electrical power output is given to the transformer and transmission from here. Transmission system from which you can connect it to the grid. Similarly, for the same grid, we will connect the thermal power plant also. Thermal power plant is also connected to the grid. So by which you can connect the hydropower plant connected to the grid, as well as thermal power plant is also to be connected to the grid. So both generating plants are operating in the same grid. Now let us take the southern grid, in which Telangana and Andhra Pradesh both are there in the southern grid. Both the states are up, comes under a southern grid, in which you have so many number of thermal power plants and hydro power plants. Example, VTPS, Vijayawada Thermal Power Plant, KTPS, Kottagudem Thermal Power Plant, Nagarjuna Sagar Hydro Power Plant, Srisailam Hydro Power Plant are the hydro power plants. Vijayaswaram, you have gas power plant. So like that, you have so many generating plants connected together to form the single grid. So that may be southern grid. If you want to control the southern grid frequency, just now in the lockdown period it was happened, scheduled control of power due to lighting operation set by the PM Modi, which was happened. Like that, if you want to operate the system securely, you need to understand the operation of the power system in detail. Along with that, you can also operate the system optimally. During crisis condition, optimal operation may not be desirable. Why? Because in order to provide the security of the power system, you need to operate the system carefully. So this is the interconnected power system, which may comprising of so many power plants, thermal power plant, and here it is hydro power plant and gas power plant. Like that, you have so many generating plants connected to the transmission system. This is the transmission, which may comprising of VHV and UHV transmission lines and power transformers feeding the load at distinct positions. This is the interconnected power system, what I described now, and hence the interconnected system operation is very important and desirable. So in order to understand the operation of the interconnected power system and its difficulties, as well as optimization process. So our optimal operation of the interconnected power system is much more desirable in the present scenario. This is the power system. So here generating plant. Here this is the plant. This is the power transformer which will increase the voltage to a high voltage, very EHV power transmission is required in order to reduce the losses as well as transmit the bulk power over long distances. It is desirable. And then this is the secondary transmission as well as distribution system. This is the distribution in which you supply the power to the residential, domestic, and here it is commercial or industrial loads as well as commercial loads and industrial loads, all loads to be supplied. As per requirements, for domestic, the cost of the unit is different, and commercial it is different, as well as the industrial it is different. For all the customers, you need to provide the power at the lowest cost. That means optimal operation is quite essential in order to operate the entire power system or entire grid. So this is the energy demand, or it is demand. This is hydropower, wind and solar. And here electric grid, this is oil, gas, coal, so thermal or fuel fired power stations. Some of the renewable power generation as well as industrial customers, domestic customer, all generating plants, load centers, transmission system, together it forms the smart grid. This smart grid is having so many components and the operation and control of various generating plants and transmission system. So therefore, in the operation and control of power system, So you need to understand each generating plant, a transmission system, and other devices in detail in order to control as well as operate them properly. So this is one website, POSOCO.in, in which Power System Operation Corporation Limited, each day wise it will provide the data as well as load curves of the country as well as grids, different grids, 5 grids. So from which you can understand the practical scenario of power systems. So this is the typical day-wise data provided by the POSOCO, the Power System Corporation Limited, Southern Region. So in the Southern Region, daily operation report of Southern Region. So I have got from the website directly. You can also go through it. This is the demand curve of the India. So it is evening peak is around 10 PM approximately, and morning peak is around 8 to 9 PM. So like that, in the typical load curve is continuously varying all over the day. For the entire day it is varying continuously. So therefore sometimes it is a valley, very low value, around 3 to 4 AM morning. So like that, from the entire curve you can understand that the load is varying dynamically, and it can be divided into base load and peak loads. During base loads, so the thermal power plants are operating. Why? Because for starting thermal power plant it will take a lot of time, and hence so thermal power plants mostly operating as base load plants. And the hydropower plant, it requires very low time to start. So around half. Therefore hydropower plants may operate as peak load plants, although it is having very high efficiency. So therefore, in order to operate the thermal and hydropower plants in coordination, you need to study the load curve, daily load curve of the nation in detail. So it is varying, the load of the nation is varying continuously. So dynamically it is varying, and hence the control is very essential. Controlling of the power plants as well as transmission system, grid. So the operation and control of frequency and voltage of the entire power system is most essential. In a nutshell, we will deal with voltage and frequency control with optimal operation in our subject PSOC. We will operate the power system and control the frequency as well as voltage, and we will also consider the optimization process, optimal operation of power plants, in addition to safety and security of the power systems. So therefore you need to understand in detail of each of the power system component for proper operation and control. So this is as and today in 2020, the installed capacity of the nation is 372 gigawatts. So previously it was 345 gigawatts, among which thermal power plant comprising of more amount. Thermal power plant almost 64%, hydro 13%, renewable 21%, nuclear 2%, gas 7%, diesel 0.24%. Among which the coal thermal power plant is, the contribution of the thermal power plant is huge, and secondly renewable as well as hydro. So these are the major sources of our country, and hence our focus is on fuel fired stations as well as hydropower stations in the optimal operation. So in subsequent chapters we will consider the frequency as well as voltage control of the power system, how to control the frequency as well as voltage. That is our motive as well as aim of the PS4C, and hence I need to explain, a teacher has to explain all these contents related to your operating the power system in practical scenario. Similarly, the student has to understand each of the component and system in detail in order to understand the concepts as well as implement the same in actual life, in practical life, and hence student has to understand it. So therefore this is the conclusion of Wit and Will, and hence I am thanking you everyone. In the next videos we will understand the fuel fired stations optimal operation in detail.